Could you explain what the tradition of Guru Shishya is? What it means from early times?
Actually, in any kind of education, I feel the relationship between Guru and Shishya needs to be formed. I would say Guru is not a person, it is a kind of a principle. Depends, Guru for you could be a book or incident. As it is defined, the word, Gu Shabdastu Andhakarasyat. Gu represents darkness. Ru Tan Nirupyate. Ru represents the removal of darkness. So, Andhakara Nirodhitvat Guru Ritya Vidhiyate. Something, a principle which removes the darkness. That is Guru. So, in any, if you want to learn something truly, go to the core of it. I feel Guru is essential. And this, I think, since time immemorial, Indian philosophy has recognized this principle. And so you will find in mythology also many pairs of Guru Shishyas, like Arjun and Krishna, you know about that. And I find the story of Dronacharya and Ekalavya very interesting. If you have heard, Ekalavya was not of a higher caste, and he wanted to learn archery from Dronacharya, who was the great guru of Kauravas. So he went to him, but Dronacharya said, no, I can't teach you because you are not of Kshatriya caste, so I cannot. But Ekalavya's faith in his guru and his capacity was so much that he made a statue of his guru. He would put it there and would take a bow and arrow and talk to the statue. Am I right? Is it okay? I should shoot like this. And this is the way he learned archery, and he became the greatest archer in the universe. So, you see, finally, it is the faith in Shishya's mind, the belief is more important. And to create that feeling in Shishya's mind, it should be Guru's aim. Every teacher is not a guru. Teacher teaches only the technique. But Guru opens the mind's eye to look to it. So, all teachers, these days it's become more in vogue to anybody starts teaching dance and they start calling themselves guru, which is really not correct. To reach to that stature for Shishya, person should be a guru. So, and it should be quest of every teacher to find that place in his Shishya's heart. And that's what connects, you know, and that's where the Shishya also starts seeing the true light in that subject. So, according to me, that is the relationship between Guru and Shishya.
And what is the attitude that a Shishya should have towards your Guru? Please, first define what is the word Shishya.
Shishya is a one who has quest for knowledge, and in that, of course, he has to have, we have two words for, we say Shraddha and Nishtha. Shraddha can be blind, it's a blind faith, it could be, but in Nishtha there is that inquisitive mind is there. But with Nishtha, when you accept that, yes, this is the person who is going to give me what I want, then he should put totally himself in his Guru's hands. And in the initially, till he, whatever the Guru has to give, till he is able to imbibe, he shouldn't ask questions. He should go on doing, and whatever the Guru says, he should go on doing it. Then there comes a point when he really gets insight into that work or subject or whatever. And in performing arts, it's all the more true. Because performing arts is concerned more with performance. But that to do that performance, your mind's eye must open. Then the true meaning will come out through that performance. And for that, for number of years, A true Shishya would just go on doing what his Guru asks without asking questions. And then comes a point when Guru himself will start telling Shishya, ask what you want to know, ask me question. When he knows that now Shishya's mind is ready, it has already imbibed the basic things, then the question answer starts, and through that more and more knowledge Shishya gains. So that should be the process. But then Guru's position also, he must understand that how much faith the Shishya puts in him. So it is his responsibility to guide him on the right path. Guru should also know his own limitations and should be open with the Shishya. See, I brought you this far. Now your way is still, you can still go ahead. So we have this saying where we say Shishyat Ichchet Parajayam. A true teacher really expects to be defeated by his Shishya. He wants the Shishya to go higher in knowledge than he has. So that's a true Guru who feels that Shishya should go higher than him. Yes.